Hello guys, Skippy Shamino here with my part 4 for Fishing Barents Sea. So I'm going to show you guys in this video how you need to fish with long lines, what you need to watch for, how you need to do it, a couple of tricks how you can speed up the time. So first of all, what you need to do is you need to understand how many lines you can get, how many storage you got in your boat. That's very important, because the main problem is that the lines need to be into the water between 18 and 24 hours, and then you got the best result on the fish. Take it from me, I went over 24 because I had too many lines into the water and there was no fish. Another thing is, you need to be 100 meters from each other, because that's normal, otherwise you're just fishing on the same spot than your other line. But I will show you guys a little bit of a trick. But first of all, we are going to start with the basics. So you need to think at the start, if you're in the dock or the harbor, what kind of fish I want to get. So let's have a look what we are going to get in this video. So first of all, so we go to the wiki. So let's have a look to the fish. So let's go for pollock. That is a really easy fish, I think, to catch. So the pollock, here is a little bit information, but we need to go to the baits. So we got 4 baits. And we need to check the baits that are good for pollock. So the shrimp is not so good, it's good for cod. Then you come to the crabs, that's 30% pollock. The krill, that's 15%. The mackerel is 55%. So mackerel is the best bait that you can get for the pollock. So we are going to put on our lines mackerel. Okay, so how do you do it? So first of all, we need to get 4 lines, because I can carry 4 lines on this boat. I'm not sure that I still got one out in the water. So let's have a look. I need to go to the map here. No, it's totally clean, so that's okay. I need to refuel. Don't forget that. That's what we are going to do first, because otherwise I need to call the helicopter to bring me back to the shore. Let's repair too. And now it's time to buy the... Yeah, I totally forgot what we need to take. Yeah, the mackerel, of course. Okay, so let's go to the fish market. And let's put some bait on our long line. So I got one long line already with shrimps. So I cannot use that for this video, because we are going for the pollock. So I'm going to put here mackerel on. So this is mackerel. You need to pay 1250 kroon for 250 meters. So you just click on this, and then you click on this, and then this is baited. Then the next one is just the same mackerel. Then we take this one and we do it again with mackerel. So now we got 3 long lines that are ready to throw into the water at some positions. Okay, so we got the bait, we got the long line. So The equipment is now ready. We got the fuel. Very important. Be always sure that you got fuel in your tank. So what we are going to do now is, now you need to find the fish, of course. So let's go to the map and just click here on pollock. So you guys will see, this is the area that I already discovered. So you guys are going to see hotspots with colors. It's not a very common fish, because if you go to the haddock, check, the hotspots are more active for that fish, but we want now pollock, okay? So first of all, pollock, I'm just going to take this point, and this point. Yeah, it's like a triangle. So we are going now first to this point. So what you need to do now is, if you take now fast travel, check, it's not going to work. Don't ask me why. But it seems that if I do this check, it's not working either. But it seems that I need to get first out of the square. For the guys that didn't saw my previous video. So that's what we are going to do. So let's get out of this dock. Go fishing. Okay, let's speed a little bit up the speed. And let's get out of this square. I'm not damaging my ship. That's always good. So the moment that you're out of the square, you can start using fast travel. Fast travel is really cool. It goes really quick. So let's go back to the map. So the first point that we are going to do, I think, was it this one? Yeah, this one. So it's not as active as those two points, but let's put the waypoint over here. nicely in the middle. Let's fast travel. And now we are at the point that we want to put out the first long line. So that's what we are going to do. So now we are here. And I'm going to put the GPS on. So it's very easy. What do you need to do now is you just need to get some speed. You can put your sonar on too if you want to check the mackerel. Not the mackerel, but the pollock. So if you see fish, you can throw it out too. But this spot is very active. So let's do the sonar first. This is redfish. But I don't think if the spot is already active, you can just throw it out. So let's wait a little bit. Maybe we got another fish. The pollock fish. I'm not even sure how it looks. Yeah, I think that's one. Okay, now you need to do this. Set gear. So take the one with mackerel, the 250, because it's not really a very active spot. Now you are going to see the meters. And now the first long line is set. So let's wait now for a moment. If you go now back to the map, you will see here a long line. You see what kind of bait we got. 250 hooks. It's now 3 minutes into the water. As already said, between 18 and 24 hours, then you are going to get the best result. The best result most of the time is 23 hours and a half, but that's not always possible because you always need to think, I got 3 lines out, I need to bring them back to the harbor because my storage is limited with the starting. So you need to think a lot that you don't miss fish. So most of the time, the first one I take a little bit sooner at 18 hours, then the next one 20, and then next one 24. Because if you go for 23 on the first one, the other two are going to be empty. Because they are going over their 24 hour and they are going to get rotten. Okay, the fish, or they are gone. Okay, the first one is out. Now we are going to the next one. That's this one. Once again, let's fast travel. Here we go. So let's go to the global market. The global map. I'm getting a little bit tired, so I think this is the right fish, the pollock. So we can just throw the right line, and this spot is very active. So let's get the 500 out here. So let's throw it out. And it's a little bit longer, of course. It got 500 hooks too. So this is 50 meters. So here we go. So almost in the half. So now he's just putting the line into the water. You guys can see it here, the meters. And then we just need to do the third one. And then we are going back to the harbor to speed up the time. Because it's possible in the harbor. It's not possible anywhere else than in the harbor. So now we go to the last hotspot. That's this one. And here we go. Okay. Let's have a look on the sonar. Let's start the boat. There is already a fish, but it's the red fish. Am I going the right way? Yeah, I'm going the right way. So if you see the pollock, we are going to throw the last line into the water. And then we need to wait until 18 hours. And then we are starting to pick up the first one. And there is the first fish. Okay, let's throw it in the water. There you go, 25 meters, and then we are done. So all the long lines are in the water. You don't need to do a lot. So now we are done. And now we just need to wait until we are at 18 hours. So how can you see it for the guys that didn't saw my last video, part 3? So here in the storage, this is a storage, but that's now empty. But here you can see it. So you see here the 3 long lines. You can see that what bait we got. And here you see the age. The age is the time that they are in the water. So the first one is already 2 hours into the water. So we still need to go a long time. But there is a trick. So I'm going to show you guys a trick. So what you can do is you can go now back to the harbor. You cannot cross, of course. I hope that they remove it. Jesus Christ. So, okay, let's go to the harbor. Is that the closest waypoint? No. Can I delete this? Yeah, okay. Okay, remove all waypoints. Okay, second try. One click. Another click. Okay, here we go. So now you go to the harbor. Okay, this is blocking two. Okay, so we need to put a waypoint here and then a waypoint here. So I hope they fix it with a hotfix because it's a little bit silly, this system. So now we are back in the harbor. And what you can do is, you first need to dock on the harbor, of course. So you can just check here the icon. So the moment that you see the icon, you just need to click on it. Yeah, and I'm very happy that my boat is even going faster than according to the info can. So I'm not sure how that's possible, because I only think he can go 7 knots. But check, now you can just click here. It's a lot faster than going to the square. And what you need to do now is, so here you can skip the time. And you only can do it in the harbor. So let's keep the time. Let's go. I'm not sure, it was 4 hours already. So yeah, I need to check something first because I want to be sure. So just go fishing again. 5 hours, my first line is into the water. So if I go, let's say, 13 hours further, it's 18 hours, but I need to go there. That's 1 hour, I think, at least two. So I think if we go 12 hours further, I think we are okay. So let's go 12 hours, skip 12 hours. Okay, skip. And now we skipped it. Okay, what you need to do now is, first of all, you need to get away from here, go fishing, get out of the square again, because otherwise the fast travel doesn't work. I'm not sure how that comes, because you guys can see it here, check. So if I put it here, I cannot fast travel. Okay, so, and I forgot to say something to you guys, the 100 meter barrier, how can you see it? Very easy. So if you fast travel and you are too close to another buoy, check, is going to say this. So that's how you can know it. So if you are, you put one buoy in the water and you want to be 100 meter further, just take a waypoint, click it around the buoy, and if it is not saying this thing, like cannot fast travel within 100 meter of fishing gear, you know that you are far enough. That's a little bit a trick. So we are almost out of the square and it's very foggy. So we are 16 hours 36 minutes on the first long line, but now we can fast travel. So let's have a look that it now works. Yeah, there we go. Okay. So now it's 17 hours and that's still too soon. That's still too soon. So we are going to fast travel a little bit further. So let's do this and let's come back. There you go. Let's have a look now. Now it's 18 hours, so it's okay. Let's try to get this stuff out of the water. We can even go a little bit further, but there is 3 hours difference, 2 hours between those two, so we cannot go that far. So what you need to do now is, you need to pick up your buoy. So now you can go back to GPS, and here you see the buoy. So let's have a look that I get a visual on it. So I think it's over there. So in the first video I had a little bit trouble with it, but what you need to do is you just need to follow the arrow and you need to go over the buoy and then you need to push E. You cannot go that fast because otherwise you go too fast over the buoy. Let's hope I can get this buoy. So let's get the speed a little bit down because 8 knots is very fast. So if you come around the buoy, you will see that you get this, and I think I'm not good, no. Or just okay? Yeah, I was just okay. So if it is green, just push E, and now it's time to get the fish in. So, oh, 1 of 10, that's not bad, because this is only 250 hooks. So that's not bad, I think they can go to 13, and now you need to do the mini game. So it's a circle that closes and you need to be very close to the smallest circle and then you do it perfect. Here we go, this is perfect. This is good again. And yeah, I hope, because this is a very good catch, I hope that I still got room, because if I need to go back to the harbor, I'm going to lose 1 hour and then it's possible that I'm going to miss the third one. So it's not that after 24 hours it's done. No, you got a little bit more time, but I'm going to lose a little bit of money. So you need to do a little bit management with this fishing. So here we go. So this is done. So we got 10 on 10. So it's already a lot of fish. I think I can storage 3000. So it's almost full, my storage. So let's gut the fish. Yeah, and this is not easy. So it depends on the wind on the sea how you can do it. I read it on the forum. So sometimes it's very hard and sometimes it's very easy. Check, this was very easy. So you guys can see it, 4.5 stars. Yeah, this was a little bit easier too, but the first two were really, really hard. Yeah, that's a good one too. Oh, one time more. Oh, is it okay? Yeah, it's okay. Okay, now we need to check. Push V. So we got now 1700 kilogram in our cargo. The main problem is that the next buoy is going to be the 500. So we need to go back to the harbor. Let's have a look. And now you can see here in the storage the quotas too, how much fish. I can still get a lot of pollock. So the gutting, the cargo, how long it's good. I think it's 8 days. Okay, the fish in the storage. So we need to watch now the 18 hours and 7 minutes on line number 2. I think we are okay. We can go back to the harbor. So let's go fast travel again with the waypoint. Okay, here we go. Okay, 19. Yeah, it's only 1 hour. We are perfect, guys. We are perfect. And where is the harbor? Can I get? Yeah, I need to get closer. My waypoint was not close enough. Okay, that's better. Here we go. Let's start the engine. It's over here. So now we are going to sell the first batch of pollock. And then the next one is going to be at 20 hours, I think, 21, and then we still got time. We need to travel 3 hours to the 250, but the 500 I want to get in, because if I got a lot of fish on that one, I think my storage is totally full, so I need to come back. So it's going to be on the edge for the last line. So we made around 21,000, so that's not bad. So it's only 14,000. No, that was a lot more. No. Oh no, it was only 13,000. Okay, but that's not bad. It's only with one line, the 250. So that's not bad. Okay, we are right away back gone. So let's get out of here. Do I got enough fuel? Yeah, I got enough fuel. You always need to watch it. Always watch a little bit fuel, because that's very important that you don't run out of fuel. So now we are going to the 500. Okay, we are out of the square. So no, this is not the 500. This is the 500. Let's put a waypoint. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, we are blocked again. Come on. Okay, here we go. Let's have a look how much time we still got. 21:56. Okay, that's almost perfect. So where is the buoy? Let's go back to the GPS. So it's going to be very tricky for the end one. I think we are gonna go over the 24 hours for that one. So I already said it, the management is very important if you fish. But yeah, the comparison between the cost for bait and the fish that you lose, it's yeah, the bait is not expensive. You guys can see it. It was 3,000 krone, I think, for the 500, or was it a little bit more? Let's try to get this buoy. I'm going a little bit too fast at the moment. So let's try to do a very good one. Please give me a green. No. Does not want to give me a green. So we are going to the other buoy because the arrow is pointing to that one. So let's get the speed a little bit down. Okay, a little bit more down. Yeah, here we go. Okay, let's hope. How many fish? 500 meter? Only 11. I expected a little bit more because this spot was a little bit better than the first one. So this one I got less fish. It was 500 meter. I waited a longer time. So yeah. But it's all pollock. You guys can see it, check. so I don't get other fish. So it's possible that we can go right away to waypoint 3 or to the line 3. Oh, that was not good. It was okay. But that's perfect. Good. Yeah, it's all pollock. Two more to go. Okay, that's perfect. Okay, let's gut the fish. So we got 277 pollock. Oh, we got 3000 kilograms. So the storage is almost full again. So it doesn't look like it, but we got so much pollock. Okay, so let's try to gut it. Let's start. Yeah, I'm not sure. 2.5 stars, maybe. 1.5, that's not good, because it needs to be more than 2 stars. Otherwise, they don't buy it. Okay, that's better. Okay, that's a very good one. Check. Okay. One time, I think. Oh, yeah, that was a very hard one. It's like, let's exit. Let's go back to V. Yeah, this, check. It's totally full. We need to go back to the harbor. What is the time on the last one? 21. Yeah, we are going to be too late. I'm already sure of it. No, I know it's very close to the harbor. So let's finger crossed that we can get it. So let's go over here. There you go. Yeah, it's blocked again. That's now 3 times that I do this. Am I the closest? Okay. So we got now 23 hours. So in these 10 minutes. What, you arrived on your final waypoint? What? Yeah, okay, that's okay. Come on, boat. Yeah, my boat is not going that fast anymore, because it's totally full with fish. You guys can see it here at the back, check. That's what I like. You can see the graphic stuff. So the thing is, I'm not going to show you guys the last buoy, so it's just the same. Repeat what you did at the first, and that's what you need to do, guys. So I was a little bit, I'm going to be like 2-3 hours wrong on the last one. So but yeah, that's what you need to do, guys. Just get the lines out, be sure that you got the bait, be sure that you know what kind of fish you're catching. So this is it's a lot of money, check. 27,000, 28,000 plus 14,000 is like 43,000 that I made in the video. But that's what you need to do, guys. So thanks for watching to my tutorial how you need to work with long lines. If you like the video, give me a like. If you like my channel, subscribe, please. Have fun in fishing Barents Sea. And I see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.